Give me some examples. Millennials don't like meetings. I just read this last week. Millennials don't like meetings. Who the hell likes meetings? What is the demographic that goes, meeting, giddy up, let's go, I gotta be in there. Jeff, I gotta cancel lunch, I got a meeting. Millennials don't like meetings, they just have the guts to say it and the naivety to think they have an influence whether they go or not. I wish I had that still. I lost it somewhere along the lines, it's gone. We don't mean millennials when we say they're different. We mean people younger than us and we're bitter. That's what it means by millennials. We're bitter they don't know what the term rewind a tape means. We're bitter they don't have to wait till Wednesday at 8 p.m. to watch a show and your sister's also trying to watch a show. They have no idea what it's like when your mom picks up the phone when you're trying to download an MP3. It takes 47 minutes to download it. We don't want to market to millennials. We want them to feel our pain. That's the difference. Just call a spade a spade. You wish you had Netflix when you were younger. I wish I had it when I was younger. But no, our parents walked to school uphill, both ways, backwards, naked. We faxed uphill, both ways, naked. And we just want them to suffer too. That's the point. You don't need to be part of their conversations on Snapchat. The reason why they're using WhatsApp is that you're not there. That's why they want to use it. Stay out of these conversations, and when they want you in the conversation, they will invite you into it. Use a platform, use a way they want to talk. You want to talk to them, they want to talk to you on a text-based message, then use a